So first of all, I would like to have a brief introduction by all participants. You got to tell me regarding your education and experience background, and you can write your introduction on the chat box, participants. So all of you, please check if your chat boxes are working and then write your introduction on the chat box. I will wait for a minute. All the participants, please write your introduction on the chat box. And participants, let me introduce myself as well. My name is Priya, and I'm a senior automation tester with 9+ years of experience in this IT field. I started my career as a .NET developer, and then I changed my career to QA after moving to US. With H2K, I work as a faculty to provide the QA, the automation, and then the certification-based courses. So this is my introduction, participants. So now I would be expecting your introduction to be written on the chat box. Yes, I can see Rachel, Divyani, Haramjeet Singh, postgraduate in the automation engineering for 4 years. Okay. Yes, all the other participants, you can write your introduction on the chat box. Devyani, your background is science, all right? Search iOS developer, very good. Yes, the other participants, please write your introduction on the chat box. Swaroop, you're new to IT and then you're graduate in the hospitality management. Very good. Devyani, you want to start your career in the QA. Nice. Moses, you're already a QA analyst with 3 years of experience. Good. Yes, all the other participants, please write your introductions on the chat box. So participants, I see your messages here on the chat box. Okay, fine. So all the participants, you're welcome to the session. So this is a session on the software testing. And this session is intended for all the participants who are interested to pursue their career as a software tester. So we'll try to understand here in this session how the software testing course would be useful for your career and what is the scope of this software testing job, if you have the job opportunities in this field or not, and then how important it is. We'll have a look at it. All right. So let's get started with the session, participants. So this will be the agenda for today. I will introduce you to our organization H2K Infosys, and then we will see what is software, how it is developed, what is BA, what is QA, the competitive edge that is provided by H2K Infosys, and then we'll have a look at schedule. So let me introduce you to our organization. We are from H2K Infosys and we are e-verified business based in Atlanta. We provide the software training, the job placement assistance, and then the job support. And this is our client network. We work with GE, AT&T, Intercall, Wells Fargo, Verizon, Sony, Bank of America, Blue Cross, Blue Shield, and many others who are located across US. And these are the world-class services that are provided by H2K Infosys. We provide the IT trainings for corporates and individuals and MS students. We do the software design, testing, and maintenance. We provide the IT staff for augmentation, the job placement assistance, and then the technical support. And these are the different courses that are provided by H2K Infosys. We provide the different types of courses like manual, automation, performance testing, SAP testing, the mainframe testing, ETL testing, mobile application testing. We have the advanced courses in the automation testing tools, HP QTP, advanced courses in the performance testing tool, HP Loadrunner. We have the BA project management, developer courses, data warehouse, SAP modules, DBA, Selenium, and many others. So we are basically into the IT trainings and placements. We are specialists in providing the IT trainings and placements. So this is an introduction to our organization participants. This is an introduction to our organization. We are specialists in providing the IT trainings and placements. I see that some of you are from non-IT background. So we'll discuss a little bit of basics about the software industry before I proceed further with the discussion on the software testing. So first of all, I guess all of you understand the meaning of software. It is set of programs that is developed for a specific purpose. For example, we have the Gmail, the Microsoft Office tools, the antivirus that protects your computer, online shopping sites. Can you give me some more examples of the software? You can write your answers on the chat box. Give me some more examples of the software that you might have come across. You can write your answers on the chat box. Give me the examples of the software. Please write your answers on the chat box. Give me examples of the software that you might have come across. So we have the ebay.com, that's right, banking application, Facebook, login and password for the bank, operating system, WhatsApp. Yes, all these are different examples of the software, the Facebook, the WhatsApp, and then the internet banking application, mobile application, the billing systems in Walmart and Macy's, all these are different examples of the software. And software is applicable to the various fields. It could be the banking industry, telecom industry, education, retail business, manufacturing companies. So you name any kind of industry, you find the application of the software. And due to this kind of wide variety of application of the software, we have a lot of IT projects that are currently in line. And the main reason why people go for the IT field because there are a lot of job opportunities available. Secondly, you get a good pay scale. The third and most important thing is, even though you're from non-IT background or you have any kind of gap in the career, you can make your career in this IT field. So this is about the software and its application. Now, to develop the software, we need to follow certain well-defined steps. First of all, we start with the requirement gathering. So we have the business analyst here who gathers the requirements from the client and shares it with the entire IT project team. Then we plan the project, do the analysis of the requirements. So this is done by the project manager and then the business analyst. Then we design the software. It's done by an architect. Developers write the programs in the development phase. The QA does the testing. And then we release the software to the client. And this is a combined effort. So this forms our IT project team. Now, though these are IT professionals, they commit certain errors or the mistakes. The human errors or the mistakes due to which the defects get introduced into the software. And when we release a defective software to the client, it results into the failure. So what is the solution here? Solution is testing. Testing is all about identifying the defects in the software, and then we make sure that we release a defect-free software to the client. And that's how the failure can be avoided. So what exactly is testing, participants? Testing is all about identifying the defects in the software, and then we make sure that we meet the requirements of the client. Then we have another interesting role, which is called as the business analysis. So we have an IT project team, and then we have the client team. The BA is acting as a liaison between the IT project team and then the client team. So as a business analyst, you have to meet the client, gather all the project information, and share it with the entire IT project team. So these are the two roles that we are currently providing. As a QA, you have to do the testing of the software. And then as a BA, you coordinate between the IT project team and then the client team. So these are the two roles that we are currently providing as a job opportunity, the QA and then the BA. So this is regarding the basics. What is software? What are its application? Why people would like to join the IT companies? What are the steps to develop the software? What is BA? What is QA? This is regarding the basics. Any questions still here, participants? Anybody has any questions still here? So now let's come to the main topic of today's session. That is software testing a good career option? And then what is its scope in the IT industry? See, the main purpose why all of you have joined today's session, you want to work in this IT field, and maybe your friends or relatives, somebody might have suggested this QA course to you, right? So before you would like to make the career in this IT field as a QA or as a software tester, you should first of all find out the career opportunities over here and also what is its scope in the IT industry. So for that, participants, you'll have to look into the job opportunities. So in other words, I would like to say that you be interested in looking into the job opportunity so that you can understand what is the scope of the QA in the IT industry and whether it's going to be a good career option for you. So first of all, we'll have a look at this question. What is the scope of QA in the IT industry? So basically here, all of you want to work in this IT field. So along with this QA, you can also go for the BA jobs. But then before that, you have to check the scope. Can you tell me, participants, how do you find the job opportunities? How do you check if there are job opportunities available? Where exactly do you check? Or with whom do you check? Yes, how do you check the availability of the QA or the BA jobs or any other IT jobs? The best thing would be, participants, to visit the job websites. You may check with your friends or people who are in the IT company and all, but still you'll not be able to get the actual numbers or the number of job opportunities that are available. So the best thing is visit the job websites. For example, we have the careerbuilder.com, the dice.com, monster.com, indeed.com. So these are the popular job websites which are used by most of the IT employers of US. So let me take you to one such website, participants, which is careerbuilder.com, and we will find the availability of the jobs here. So let me take you to the careerbuilder.com. So this is a career builder website, participants, wherein you can search the jobs. You can enter the name of the role here. For example, let me search the job opportunities for the IT project manager. So you type the job title here or the job role and click on the find jobs button, and it will display the number of jobs that are available. So do you see here more than 2500 jobs are available for the IT project manager role? And do you see here, participants, you can view or you can refine your searches here. Let's say this is the data for the last 30 days, different kind of employments, like if you're looking for a full-time, part-time, you can check it here. What is the annual pay that you're expecting? And do you see, we also have the job categories over here wherein you can make the search. All right, so you can give the search here. Let me check for the business analyst position. I will type BA. And then click on the find jobs button. So do you see? Again, we have plenty of job opportunities that are available. I can search for the developer position. For example, I search Java developer. Click on the find jobs button. So do you see here, participants, compared to the BA and IT project manager jobs, the Java developer jobs are less in number, 1,1994. Another example, let's say I want to check for the .NET architect. I can type here .NET architect. Click on the find jobs button. So you see here only 442 jobs. Now let's search for the QA jobs. Type QA. Click on the find jobs button. So do you see, again we have plenty of jobs. About 2500 jobs are available here. So here you can find the statistics of the different IT based jobs, the number of job opportunities that are available. So do you see here, participants, you have lot of job availabilities here in the IT industry for three important positions, that is IT project manager, the BA role, and then we have the QA role. So we have the IT project manager, the BA role, and then the QA role. For all these three positions, we have the highest number of job opportunities over here. And that is why, participants, you can consider QA or a BA as one of the job role that you could try for. Secondly, you have to check whether these roles are going to suit your background. So let me tell you that these roles are technology independent roles. Wherein you need not do any kind of programming. Anybody from non-IT background, anybody who has a gap in the career, they can make their career in this IT field as a QA or even as a BA. Because just have a look here, participants. Is it possible that you get the or you develop the software without the project information? Yes. Can you develop the software without project information? And Synergy, I will be coming to your question. I will discuss the question in the class. All right. I've seen your question on the chat box and your question will be answered. So participants, tell me one thing. Without the project information, can we develop the software? The answer is no. It means that in each and every IT project, we definitely have the job opportunity for the business analyst. And without testing, we cannot release a software to the client. So both of them are called as primary roles in the IT project team. Both of them are called as the primary roles in the IT project team. And why these roles are suitable for the people from non-IT? Now, do you see here, participants, when I was searching for the job opportunity for a developer position, I was typing here .NET developer or a Java developer, .NET architect or a Java architect, because these are technology-based roles. So you can say that if it is a Java-based project, we cannot hire the .NET developers, or if it is a .NET project, we cannot hire the Java-based developers. So here their roles are technology dependent. If it is a Java project, then we should hire the Java developers or the architects only, and they are not eligible to make their career in any other fields. But then if you consider the project manager, BA or the QA role, the technology doesn't matter here. It doesn't matter on which technology the software is being developed, whether it's a Java technology, .NET technology, SAP, anything. For all the IT projects, for all the software development project, we can hire the BA, QA, and then the project managers. So your role is not dependent on the technology. The technology of the software doesn't matter to you. You can test the Java-based technology project, or you can test the .NET based software, or you can test the SAP based software, any kind of technology based software you can test as a QA or gather the requirements as a BA and manage the project as a project manager. So all these three roles are technology independent. And this is how the number of job opportunities also increase. For example, let's say there are 10 projects here. For example, let's say there are about 10 projects here. Five of them are on the Java, three of them .NET, and then the remaining two on some other technology. So participants, if you're a Java developer, you can apply only for the five projects, means your job opportunity is 5 out of 10. If you're a .NET developer, you can apply only for 3 projects here, means your job opportunity is 3 out of 10. But if you're a QA, BA or a project manager, you can apply for all the 10 projects, means your job opportunity is 10 out of 10. So do you see here, participants, the number of jobs or the job opportunity will increase if you're going for the QA, BA and then the project manager. So this is one important reason, participants, why the people would be interested for these positions. So here This is why I would say, if you are a non-technical person, if you do not have an IT background, then software testing would be a good career option for you. Along with software testing, you can also consider the BA, which will maximize your job opportunities. So here, participants, the BA and QA position, both of them are primary roles. So you go to any kind of IT project team, you definitely have a job opportunity as a BA and then the QA. And in most of the projects, we hire BA plus QA. Since recession, it has been into practice that we would like to hire the candidates of the multiple skills. And this could save the cost of the project. And that is why, participants, we have the BA plus QA positions here. So along with testing, you can also coordinate with the other members of the IT project team. So this is regarding the job opportunities. Anybody has any questions still here, participants? Anybody has any questions still here? I have two questions here from Synergy and Rashan. I will note down the question here on my screen. So first question, I will answer it later. Second question, the bachelor's degree is required? Not exactly. We are not much interested in the education background or the work background over here, because all these roles that I'm suggesting, they are independent of technology. All right, they are independent of technology. If you have it, is good. It's always better to have a lot of certifications, degrees on your resume. But anyways, for the BA, QA and IT project manager job, it's not mandatory. And then participants, so what are the skills that you need to have then? If you want to work as a BA or a QA, you need not have the IT background, then what skills do you need to have? You need to have the good communication skills. You need to have the good documentation skills, the decision making skills, so you need to have basically this kind of soft skills, and which you can develop during our QA or the BA course. All these skills, participants, you can develop during the QA or the BA course, because we are going to provide you the sufficient practice. This is going to be job-oriented and professional course that we are conducting, and all these skills you can develop it during our course. There is one more question here that I would like to answer right away. Payment-wise, which is better, the BA or a QA? So here I would like to suggest, go for the BA plus QA. You will get the better payment. But if you want to consider them individually, both the BA and QA will start initially with the same payment structure. But then if you start your career as a business analyst, you will be reaching the role of a project manager. And then if you start as a QA, you will reach your position as a test manager. All right, test manager is the highest position for you as a QA. And then the test manager position comes under the project manager role. So obviously, if you consider the long run, it's a project manager, means if you start as a BA, the BA plus project manager will be highly paid than compared to the test manager. But I would always suggest go with these together, the QA plus BA, and then the payment would be more than the individual ones here. The payment will be more, and also it will improve your chances of getting the jobs in the project. So these were some questions on the chat box. Now participants, let's have a look at the QA course syllabus that is provided by H2K Infosys. So this is a QA course syllabus, participants, that is provided by H2K Infosys. And we start right from the basics. The basics of software engineering and testing, because we are aware that most of the participants who are enrolling in this QA or a BA course are from non-IT background, and that is why we start right from the basics. And then we have the second one here, manual testing, wherein we are conducting the project-based sessions. Documentation will play a major role here in this topic. Then Quality Center, it's a test management tool, SQL, using which we will show how to test the database, Unix and Linux operating system, automation testing using HP QTP, and we will use the latest version of the QTP, which is called as UFT. We'll test the performance of the software using HP Loadrunner. SAP testing, web services using SOAP UI tool, ETL and data warehouse testing using Informatica tool, mobile application testing, the big data concepts, core Java concepts. So these are the 13 different topics, participants, that we are going to cover under this QA course. So this is a complete QA course package that we are providing. And all these courses are available at a price of one course. At a price of one course, all these topics are available. And it takes about 100 plus hours for us participants in order to complete this entire QA course. In order to complete this entire QA course, it takes more than 100 hours for us. Now, can you tell me, participants, after the completion of the QA course, what will you do? Yes, what will you do, participants, after the completion of this QA course? It's obvious that you start applying for the jobs, right? You start applying for the jobs, correct? And for the jobs, you require the resume. So we will assist you here with the resume preparation, participants. So why do you need our assistance for the resume preparation? You must be knowing that, let's say this is a monster.com database. There are already so many resumes that are dumped here, and if you are creating an account and if you are uploading your resume, it will be another resume that will get dumped here. And then when the employer is searching for the QA resume here, QA resume, lot of resume will pop up on his screen. Let's say your resume appears somewhere on the 200th position. Now, can you tell me, participants, what is the chance that employer will view your resume? Do you think he will check all the 200 resume, 500 resume, or all the resume that are present in the database? He will not. He will basically look for the resume that are on the top, let's say top 10 resume, top 20 and top 30, and he will send the interview. He will send the interview link or the interview session request for the candidates who are appearing on the top, right? Even the same thing happens with you. Let's say you do a Google search, you're searching for some QA job or you're searching for some QA material. Whatever links are appearing on the top, you basically click on those links. You never go to the 10th page or you never go to the 5th page and then you click on all those links. Basically, whatever search results are appearing on the top, you'd like to click on them and then you view the content because they are the best matches for your search. So similarly here also, when the employer is searching for the QA resume, whatever resume appear on the top positions here will get the interview calls. Okay, the ones that are appearing on the top will get interview calls because the employer assumes that they are the ones with the best match. So if you don't prepare a proper resume, your resume never comes on the top and you never get an interview call. In order to assist you, participants, on the resume preparation, we are conducting the resume preparation classes here. So we will tell you how to prepare a resume in such a way that your resume appears on the top list and then you have more probability of getting the interview calls. And then let's say you get an interview call. So what happens during the interview? The questions will be asked by the interviewer and then you have to give the answers. So obviously, participants, when so many different topics are covered, you have more skills on your resume, you have more knowledge, and that is why you will be able to answer more number of questions when compared to the other candidates. And that is how you will have the edge over other candidates. But then the way you answer also matters. Just because you know everything, you can't answer everything there. How much you have to answer for a particular question, how you have to organize the information that you have, how you have to present your answers, this you will learn in our unlimited hours of mock interview sessions. And then we have the different domain-based learning here. We will conduct the different domain-based learning. Project-based sessions are conducted here. Testing tools will be installed on your computers, participants. So these are the additional services that are provided by H2K Infosys apart from these 13 different topics. So it is 13 different topics plus these additional services that I have listed over here. So this is a complete QA course package. So I will wait for a minute, have a look at it, participants, and then we will proceed further. I'll wait for a minute. Please have a look on it. And then if you have questions, please post on the chat box and we'll proceed further. So I guess everyone have had a look at this one. And I think there are some questions here. Let me put the questions here on the screen. Will you be the trainer for all the concepts? Obviously not, Kalpana, because I'm not an expert in all the fields and nobody can be, in fact. because we just do not want to train you like a layman and we want to train you like a professional. So I have my experience and expertise in certain topics for which I will be conducting the sessions, and all the other sessions like mobile application testing, or it could be the SAP testing, we would be inviting the experts from the field who will take the training for you. Because a person cannot be expert in all these fields. And if anybody claims to say so, you know that if they can take all the topics, definitely not. They cannot be the experts, all right? So we would like to get you trained from an expert, people who have a lot of experience in the field, the hands-on practice on the tools. And that is why we have the different trainers for the different topics, experts of the field. Regarding the certificate, yes, I'll again come back to this question. Can I just do the manual testing to start with? Swaroop, you can do so, but that will not be much useful for you because the industry has changed in such a way that if you go to the job opportunity, I mean, if you attend any kind of job interview, now just, you know, imagine there are other participants, there are other candidates there who are manual testers, I mean, who are automation testers, who have the certification, who are also the QA plus BA. When there are so many competitive people around you, now tell me, just as a manual tester, what is your chance of getting a job? Basically, the employer would look for a candidate who have the multiple skills. The candidate should have many skills, or let's say he should be an expert, right? So if you just learn the manual testing and then try to present your resume, I don't think so. It would be preferred when there are more candidates who are more competitive and more skilled than you. So if you have to be competitive, try to add more and more skills on your resume. Try to learn more and more technologies, get in-depth knowledge, do hands-on practice, learn the testing tools, and that's how you're going to get the jobs easily. Otherwise, you may have to struggle a lot. Clear, Swaroop? I don't say that you will not get the job, but then you'll have to put a lot of efforts on that part. Instead of that, put the efforts here in your class and then learn more techniques, more testing tools. And that is how the further path would be easier for you. So I'd like to show you the next course that is available with us participants, that is the BA Project Management. So let's see the syllabus for the BA Project Management. So here on my screen, you can see the BA plus project management course, which you can take up with the QA. So this is QA plus BA project management course. Now, who is a project manager? A project manager is the head of this entire IT project team who will plan and control all the activities of the project. And if you want to work as a project manager, you got to start your career as a business analyst. You want to start your career as a business analyst. So we have the BA plus project management here, the roles and responsibilities, the different techniques, the diagrams, the documents, the methodologies, and then the tools that are used by the BA and project manager. And to train you on this project management course and the BA course, we have a project manager with 16 plus years of experience in this IT field. A project manager who is PMP certified since last 6+ years, a project manager who has a training experience since last 7 years. So this person will be taking the training for you. So I mentioned to you, right, we will get the experts here to train you on the courses. And for the BA project management, we have the project manager himself who is PMP certified, who will be training you on this BA plus project management course. So this is a BA plus project management course that we have. Now participants, let's have a look at the different services that are offered by H2K Infosys. So here you see participants, we have the huge course syllabus. So you take any course from us, the syllabus is really huge, covering a lot of topics because we want to make sure that you're able to get the jobs easily. And then we have all the US-based instructors who will train you on these courses because we want to make sure that you're trained based on the projects. The project-based training should be done and which will suit the IT environment of US. And this is pay only one time. You can retake the sessions any number of times that you want. We help you with the resume preparation and mock interview session. We install the software on your computers. We do the domain-based learning here. We give you the assignments and then review the work. Training is based on latest technologies and current job market. We have the forums, blogs, videos, and then the job portals. So these are the different services that are offered from H2K Infosys along with the courses that you're going to enroll. So you take any course with us, all these services would be applicable. Now, these are some more services and I would like to take you to our website. It is www.h2kinfosys.com. So if you visit our website, participants, you can find a lot of information here. So we have the courses tab here, and under the courses tab, you have the list of courses that are provided by H2K Infosys. Quality assurance, business analysis, and so on. If I click on this BA, scroll down, the complete syllabus is displayed on our website. So participants, we are quite transparent about the topics that we are providing, the syllabus that we are offering. All the information is available here. And then we conduct the project-based sessions. We have the forums wherein you can interact with other candidates of H2K Infosys. We have the videos available and also the job opportunities provided. So these are the different services that we have included in our QA course and also the BA project management. So we have a lot of information available here. Job portal from where you can apply for the jobs. Forums wherein you can interact with each other and build your professional network. We are conducting the project-based sessions here. Course materials will not only include the detailed materials, but we also provide you with the pre-recorded videos for all the topics, which are extremely helpful to revise after the class. And then you can find the reviews of H2K Infosys on Google+, Kudzu, Facebook, and YouTube. For the job placement assistance, we have the job placement team available. So these are the different services that are provided by H2K Infosys. These are the different services that are provided by H2K Infosys. So now, let me give you the details here regarding the different batches that we are conducting. And before that, participants, there are some more questions here that I would like to answer. Can you tell more specific about your course? So I think this question is answered, Sergi, the QA and the BA course. So I gave you the complete syllabus, the topics that we cover, and also the services. And then how long it is. So the duration of the course will be about 2 to 3 months. What kind of certificate you get? You get the course completion certificate. Does the certificate have the value for the employer? Yes, for the completion of the course, we provide you the certificate. But then there are certain certification examinations that you may have to take up if you want to add more value to your resume. All right, if you want to add more value to your resume, you can write the certification examinations and we will give the suggestions regarding this one as well. So it will be the part of your QA course package itself. We'll give you the assistance or we will provide you the suggestions regarding the certification examinations that you can write, which can add more value to your resume. Some more questions here. Will the BA plus QA course cover the course you showed under the QA program? Yes, Devyani. I will give you the course structure now, how you have to enroll. What kind of help is provided in the job placement? So we provide the complete course package with all the hands-on practice and the real-time scenario-based or the project-based sessions that will be conducted over here. So this will be project-based sessions, which will help you to perform in your job. We will provide you the resume preparation assistance, and then the mock interview sessions that will be conducted, and these are unlimited hours of mock interview sessions. And we will also set up an interview with our clients. We will present your resume and we will set up the interview with the client. So this will be the placement assistance that we are going to provide. There are two more questions here, and let me explain these questions. Before that, I would like to give you the details regarding the batches. So we are conducting the QA batches here. 9 a.m. Eastern and then 2:30 p.m. Eastern. These two are Monday to Friday batches. We have one more batch at 8 p.m. Eastern, and this is Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Then we have the BA Plus project management batches, 10 a.m. Eastern, 8 p.m. Eastern, and then 10:30 p.m. Eastern. All this is Monday to Friday batch. And the most important thing about the BA Plus project management batches that I would like to mention is the topic that is discussed in the 10 a.m. Eastern would be repeated in 8 p.m. Eastern and 10:30 p.m. Eastern. Means you can choose any of these batch. If you miss one batch here, I mean one timing, you can attend any of the other sessions over here. And also if you want to revise, you can attend more than one session on the same day. So the same topic will be conducted in all the three batches. But then for the QA, it's not like that. The different topics will be going on because the start dates for these QA batches will be different. Now, participants, I would like to give you the course suggestion. So the course suggestion is you can take up this QA course along with the BA project management. So this is our course suggestion. And if you're taking these two courses together, participants, every day you will have to attend two classes. One is QA and another is BA project management, and you can choose your batches based on your convenience. You can choose the batches based on your convenience. So together it will be 2 to 3 months. So the duration together it will be 2 to 3 months, and we are going to conduct the sessions parallelly. Now for the enrollment participants, you have to call us on this number 770-777-1269. And we are available from 9 a.m. Eastern to 9:30 p.m. Eastern on all the 7 days of the week. And regarding the start date and then the price of the course, you'll have to discuss with H2K Infosys. I think so these questions are also answered here. Another question, how long is each session? It will be 1 hour session. All the sessions are going to be 1 hour. 1 hour session per day. So participants, this was the information that I had to provide. In case you have any questions, you can please ask. All the participants, if you have any questions, please ask. If anybody still has any questions, please ask participants. Will all the jobs be entry level? Well, Rachel, you can decide. Like somebody mentioned here, they already have the experience of the manual testing. So basically, you can directly go for the advanced courses if you want. So based on the experience or based on the expertise that you have, you'll be applying for the different level of jobs. But it is always better if you're from non-IT, start with the entry level job. What is the initial pay for these jobs? Well, Devyani, this information, you can get it here from this. Websites, do you see we have the careerbuilder.com website here. So we have the QA positions over here, and you can search for the different QA position and also find out the pay rate. Do you see? The salaries are also mentioned. You can check here on these job websites. Any other questions, participants? All right. So participants, okay, there is another question here. What should be the basic education or experience for the BA program? There is no need of any such experience over here, because anybody from non-IT background can also apply for this course. All right. Anybody from non-IT background can also apply for this course. And Kalpana, regarding the weekend classes, you will have to check with H2K Infosys. Regarding the weekend sessions, please check with H2K Infosys. So participants, I guess these were your questions. So it was nice interacting with all of you. So this was Priya here from H2K Infosys, and we will meet during the QA course. Thanks for attending the session, participants. And here on my screen, you can find our contact details. You can call us on this number 770-777-1269, or you can even contact us through the email training@h2kinfosys.com. You can visit our website www.h2kinfosys.com. Thank you, participants, for attending the session today. Everyone have a good day.